voices in my head won't shut up and stop. Sweat dripping down my face and it ain't even hot. I can't watch the TV no more, cause it seems the people in the TV are coming out at the screen. People walking past me sticking my brain. I took myself to the doctors, cause it's clear I'm going insane. I need help, my mind's on repeat, it keeps playing. Visions that are so grotesque, I can't say it. Sick imagination, evil hallucinations. I'm paranoid and scared, life has become weird. It's getting to the point I'll say suicide is an option, cause I can't carry on this way. I can't eat food cause it's infected with germs. The spaghetti on my plate turns to poisonous worms. I know it ain't real, I know it's in my mind right there. My everyday life's an everyday nightmare. I tell you how it all started, the Friday just gone. Me and my boys were blasting skunk and passing it on. We all got lean and buzzing, talking and smoking, enjoying our high, laughing and joking. The buzz was dope, I enjoyed what it did to my brain. But the very next day I woke up, it was strange. I was seeing things that weren't even there. How do I know? Cause when I blinked it disappeared. I became obsessed with thinking thoughts, that's nuts. How so many things can go inside your mind at once. My brain was on overload, to the point it felt like it was gonna explode. Now I'm just trampy, smelling, walking on road, talking to myself. I need help, my mental health is in a crisis, and a healthy mind is priceless. I don't wanna die like this. It's time to talk about the madness in the hood, cause mental illness is bringing sadness in the hood. The drugs we put in our brain cells isn't good, it catches up to you. Mental illness is the worst thing that can happen to you. I'm going through it, you can't do nothing when your mind's eternally sick. It's time to talk about the madness in the hood, cause mental illness is bringing sadness in the hood. The drugs we put in our brain cells isn't good, it catches up to you. Mental illness is the worst thing that can happen to you. I'm going through it, you can't do nothing when your mind's eternally sick. She was pretty and light skinned, body was buff, no fat, just curves. Have you lost for words when you saw her? Everybody in the hood was on her, painting, beautiful girl, true Madonna. 15 years old with stunning good looks, beauty and the brains, her head was in her books. She was a good girl, even though she would roll with the skets of the neighborhood, she wasn't a hoe. Enough man tried, but she kept her legs closed tight. She didn't wanna have sex till the time it was right. Her mind was bright, but a bit naive to say. She never drank or did drugs until one day she was at a drink up with all of her friends. She showed up, even though she didn't wanna attend, cause she fooled with her man early on in that day. She wanted to go home, but he was egging on her to stay, cause he wanted to hit. He had made up his mind that today he was gonna break her V this time. It's been 2 years, we've been going unsteady. How you gonna still tell me that you ain't ready, is what he said. She replied, look baby, I love you, in time we will do it, but I'm still not comfortable. He wasn't having that and told her straight up, look, if we don't do it now, then you lose me for good. She said, now you're going on like sex is all it's about. She started wiling and cussing, so we told her to bow. She stormed out the house, later on hit the drink up, hoping that the night will get her over her breakup. She never ever smoked stuff before, like never ever. When her friends passed her a tooth, she refused. But this time her friends said, just take one blast, Gemma. Where she was down and depressed, she figured whatever. Her first blast, she coughed the smoke out of her throat. Then she smoked the rest of the zoo down to the roach. 5 minutes later, she was dazed and confused, laughing, shouting, running naked round the room. Her friends tried to calm her down cause she was way too excited, but it only got worse cause now she was fighting. They had to call the police and doctor to get her, cause she wouldn't calm down and she hasn't got better. Got sectioned to a mental health home, paranoid schizophrenia was her diagnosis. 6 months later, she was back on the road under her parents' care. But it didn't matter much cause she hardly was there. She was running crow daily, addicted to the same drug that made her mind crazy. Fiending for it, stealing from her mum's purse so she could go get a hit. And when that stopped real quick and she ran out of dough, she would fuck one of her dealers in return for some crow. She lost her V prostituting on the streets, from getting fucked in the park to dodgy car meets. Her friends all ditched her cause she got too strange, talking to the trees, rocking same clothes for days, begging strangers for change. It's sad how she's changed, 15 years on she's only got worse, walking up and down the streets with no nurse. In the middle of the road pissing, you can't recognize her cause her front teeth's missing. Bear can in her hand all the time, it's only adding to the problem that troubles her mind. I see her all the time, she sleeps on the streets, skinny as hell cause She hardly ever eats, her hair's in a mess, never ever done. Bogey on her nose cause she just lets it run. Her clothes are ripped up, dirty and have stains. She argues with herself cause she's totally insane. When you look at her now it's hard to believe that she once looked like a school beauty queen. It's time to talk about the madness in the hood, cause mental illness is bringing sadness in the hood. The drugs we put in our brain cells isn't good, it catches up to you. Mental illness is the worst thing that can happen to you. I'm going through it, you can't do nothing when your mind's eternally sick. It's time to talk about the madness in the hood, cause mental illness is bringing sadness in the hood. The drugs we put in our brain cells isn't good, it catches up to you. Mental illness is the worst thing that can happen to you. I'm going through it, you can't do nothing when your mind's eternally sick. We went to school together, me and my best friend, close as jam and toast, my tightest brethren. We fought the same way, spat bars for days. Church, girls on road, rob geeks for change. Like the same tunes, rock the same clothes. Had the same type, hit the same holes. We would only ever argue over things real silly. Like he would say punks to illness, I say nah it's biggie. Little things like that, but let me lay this fact and tell you how a white cloud can turn to black. See my boy was a deep thinker, he would touch on subjects that were much deeper than the average subject that most of man never would discuss. Like how the government secretly spying on us, and one day we'll control not only our bodies but our minds and our souls. And on he would go. Deep thinking and running stunt don't mix. The combination of the two makes the mind play tricks. And that's what I told my boy, but it just didn't click into his ear. I told him about what happened to me, he didn't care, and started running Zeus on stairs. It became a regular thing for him to cop draws of skunk, filling them up non-stop. Months down the line I noticed changing his mood, not hollering and becoming quite a recluse. That's when I got the call from his brother. He told me just passed out and now he's in a coma. I rushed to the hospital to visit him. Tried talking to him but was clear he wasn't listening. Instead he said, shh, can't you hear them voices whispering? There wasn't any voices, asked the doctors what's got into him. The doctor said your friend's got psychosis sadly, and it's gonna take a while for him to snap in reality. Cannabis is triggered off the illness he has. All the potent that he's smoking is sending him mad. Years went by, he was released from the hospital, but he was slower than communicate properly. He wasn't the friend that I once knew. I always hoped that one day he would come through, and one night I think that he actually did. We was busting jokes at each yard just like when we was kids, until he ran out of six and asked me go to the shop, cause he wasn't allowed to leave the hostel that he got. I said cool and left, 20 minutes gone I was back. Ringing on his phone, knocking the door, but no response. I could hear his phone ringing, so he hasn't gone.
Hey Jess, you're one, fam, open the door.
I got a bad feeling, so I booted in the door, but there was something jamming it from moving on the floor. I pushed on it some more. When I got in, I could see that it was weights. The next thing I saw put a shock on my face. My brethren was hanging from a wire around his throat, descending from the ceiling. My eyes couldn't believe it. I rushed to him quick, threw the chair out the way that he must have just kicked. Tried to pull him up, but it was too late. Why? I could see that there was no life left in his eyes. My boy's committed suicide. On the floor, read a note. The voices in my head won't stop, I can't cope. Time to talk about the madness in the hood, cause mental illness is bringing sadness in the hood. The drugs we put in our brain cells isn't good, it catches up to you. Mental illness is the worst thing that can happen to you. I'm going through it, you can't do nothing when your mind's eternally sick. It's time to talk about the madness in the hood, cause mental illness is bringing sadness in the hood. The drugs we put in our brain cells isn't good, it catches up to you. Mental illness is the worst thing that can happen to you. I'm going through it, you can't do nothing when your mind's eternally sick.